We are describing the finite-state machine. Finite-state machine is very useful because the finite-state machine is used everywhere in deterministic PPA, including machine. The finite-state machine, like a two-part language or two-part language, any or two-part MNN is correlation, derivative detection, all this can be finite state machine. Gate can move between this, and later on if you allow the gate, this detection also, that doesn't pop, that doesn't enhance pop. So if you put it here block, that doesn't limit. So if you allow in both direction, but if you give the right permission, then it will be like a correlation. So, the FSM formalization was done in 1949, even after purification, that is changed. But purification definitely aware of finite state machine. But more formalization exists before that. All mechanical machines, whatever mechanical things, all of finite state machine. So, here is the deterministic PPA, here if requirement, if requirement, manage, opening places, closing places, this. This thing can be done by here. Gate can be in this direction and this state is top. And if it is FSM, we accept this state as the action chain B. And you know which is empty here, then it is accepted. If it is the stat is not empty or FSM is not accepted state, then PPA doesn't accept the language. So, which is very important because the Turing machine can solve this problem also. Much efficient current here. So, equivalent can be solved by a Turing machine also. But you might argue which kind of machine you should employ, you should prefer definitely P. But PPA formalization through Vettelin comes much later, 1959-60. But here, PPA is enormously used for this. Our most powerful machine, it is theoretical machine by Alan Turing. And here, the difference is it can. And this way also, this way also. And here we can show that how we can double shut double. So it is just check, first check the this character, then it cross this one at a time, this one at a time, and this one at a time. And fit them with another six character, say C hash, C to C hash, C hash, C hash. Then again, traverse. If it sees that any A, any B extra, then it will go to each AC. So that way, it accepts convolution as double. So this is, and if you put a bound on it, that is linear bound from order, generally we are not much interested because most of the case is a Turing machine. And we have shown it that there are multi-K, multi-K, and basically this machine can be replaced by single K. Another beautiful thing is this FSM configuration. This FSM configuration, you have to make it a trap here. In FSM configuration, you can put it in this portion of the tail. After reading this, it should not change. After reading only, the FSM configuration can be desired configuration to detect the data. Data is here, program is here. So this portion is program. This portion is program. After reading this, and after this the data, this portion is data. This is universal Turing machine. Universal Turing machine can solve any algorithm. So that's the beauty of it. So we know there are some problems which cannot be solved. Like jigsaw problem, we have shown Turing or Turing problem. That means you cannot design a program and if you put it as directly the Turing machine, which is not possible. So that is Turing. So that's it.